cup of the morning to you, Wandering Tea Lover. Afternoon? Evening? Anyway, so last week I read Leviathan Wakes by James S.A. Corey. So you know I'm more of a fantasy fiction reader and not as much into science fiction apart from the Isaac Asimovs, a few Philip K. Dicks here, a few Arthur C. Clarke's there. But having been immersed in the fascinating world of our solar system all of last week, I feel like I've been missing out. As you can see, I'm quite fond of the solar system. Set in a colonized solar system, Leviathan Wakes is a space opera full of mystery, intrigue, adventure, romance, excitement, you name it, spun to the backdrop of space, which makes it amazing to read. Not since Star Trek have I come across a story promising a positive, non-apocalyptic future for humanity. Corey was able to paint a picture which not only gave me a good idea of the scale of space, but also zoomed into the lives of some very relatable and interesting characters. So I was truly able to appreciate the bigger picture while looking at the finer details. Like I mentioned in our last video, I wanted to see if I still enjoy the book better, even if I watch the show first. And the short answer is yes, the book is definitely still better. The long answer is, even though I loved the show, the book was able to fill in a lot of details the show wasn't able to. You know how the show starts with a montage of what Julie Mao is going through, but we don't really get to know her as a person or feel what she's feeling, which of course we are able to in the book. The book also filled in a lot of background and gaps that the show left. Overall, I'd say a must read for space enthusiasts. Next week, I'll be reading The Devourers by Indra Das. I've been feeling a bit nostalgic for home lately, and set in Calcutta, the book promises to take me back mentally, if not physically. Genre-wise, it's right up your alley, it's speculative fiction and dark fantasy. So I'll see you on the other side if I make it out alive.
Hello, Susharajha. So this week I have been reading Winter Tide by Ruthanna Emrys, and let me tell you a little about it. The book is set during the Cold War time period, and what we are dealing with is whether the Soviets are indulging in maybe the use of magic to actually win this war. And the US government wants that secret, and they won't be able to actually leverage that far away from them. Afra Marsh and her friends are supposed to uncover the truth, and along the way also uncover their own heritage, their own life, and understand what they are supposed to do with their own selves now that they are the last of their species. This book, I will be very honest, was beautiful to read. It was beautiful to read because finally you get to see more than monsters, and the fear and paranoia that is the Cthulhu mythos actually doesn't fade away as much, but it transfers. The book is fantastic because it delves into the lives of the deepwaters. It adds in the culture, it adds in their values, it adds in the systems. We may not understand it in the beginning, but we slowly get to understand what it is that runs their lives, and that is magic. One of the best threads in this entire system is the kind of magic that they actually use. It is engaging, it is beautiful, it is deep, and it is simple. You get to learn about the deep ones, you learn about the great ones, you learn about the whole litany of who all are in there. There is an entire explanation of their gods and their culture and their brilliance and their falls. And it is beautifully told. The plot may be very simple. Yes, it is a very simplistic plot. A lot of people might have an issue with that, but it's not the plot that actually runs the story, it's the depth of character that each and every one of them have in there. That's all for now. I will be reading Skulls Worn by Brian Staveley this week, and I will tell you all about it next time. Bye!